So I'm going to talk about the estimation of the biomass, which give us the carbon. So what happens in trees, we have the process of photosynthesis, whereby the plant take in the CO2 through that process, then it stores this CO2 in form of biomass. Now, the 50% of that biomass is carbon. So whatever we do, we estimate to one variable in the forest, that is the diameter at breast height. Then with this diameter, we use allometric equations. We have two types of allometric equations. We have the general allometric equations. For instance, we have Komiyama 008 for above ground biomass and Komiyama 005 for the below ground biomass. We also have specific site-specific equations. And in Kenya, we only have one site-specific equation, but that one was done in Jazi for the Rhizophora species. So in our case, we are going to use the general allometric equations. So these equations, they have two variables, the diameter which are taken from the field, and then we have the wood densities. Then the wood densities for these trees, we have a research which was done in Gazi, is a representative for the Kenyan mangroves. So we have wood densities for the different mangrove species. So with these two variables, the wood density and the diameter, we can fit into our allometric equation to get the amount of biomass. Now, this biomass, we multiply it by 0.5 for the above ground biomass to get the above ground biomass carbon. Then for the root biomass, we multiply it by 0.39 to get the root biomass carbon. Then we add the two to get total vegetative carbon. Then from the vegetative carbon, we also do the coring, whereby we get the sediment or the soil organic carbon. Then the three pools will give us the total ecosystem carbon. Now, when we have the total ecosystem carbon of this plot, it's a plot of 10 by 10. We extrapolate that 10 by 10 into per hectares. Then we can also convert the carbon we have into CO2, which is still CO2 equivalent. And we have the molecular ratio of CO2 to carbon, which is 44:12. That gives us 3.67. So our amount of carbon per hectare times 3.67 will give us the amount of CO2 which has been trapped from the atmosphere, and it is stored in our plot or in our vanga area.